This is huge, guys. Pinterest finally came up with some very important information that will help us keep our accounts safe and within Pinterest spam policies. We've been waiting for years to get a little bit of clarity about the limits of pinning on Pinterest, and I'm happy to see that Pinterest started giving us some idea of what can get us caught into spam filters. Hi, I'm Anastasia of AnastasiaBlogger.com. I'm a Pinterest marketing expert. And in today's video, you will learn what is changing in Pinterest's best practices this year, how you need to adjust your strategy to get the best results from your efforts on this platform. And also, I will show you how some of the new features introduced by Tailwind Scheduler and developed in collaboration with Pinterest can help you stay within the recommended pinning limits and avoid getting your account suspended on Pinterest. Tailwind and Pinterest made together an hour-long live session where they share the best practices for Pinterest marketing for this year. But I will do my best to give you a short version with the most essential information so you don't get your account suspended. And before I tell you the pinning limits, I need you to understand something. Pinterest cannot publish any specific numbers or limits on their official pages because it would be equal to giving an exact recipe to people who want to abuse the system. So what Pinterest is doing instead, they're giving the good folks who want to follow the rules a little bit of guidance from their authorized partner. Technically, Tailwind Scheduler will now show us certain pinning limits and alert us if we're going overboard and saving the same pin too many times or saving too many pins a day. The new Tailwind features are called SmartGuide and Spam Safeguard. Here are the questions that people asked me here on YouTube and in my course about 3,075 times so far, and I always had to answer based on my experience and on the little pieces of information we could catch here and there from a few interviews Pinterest representatives gave in the last couple of years. But now we know that Tailwind mentioned specific numbers on their page about Pinterest best practices. And I will give you a link to that page in the description below this video so you can always get back to it and see if they made any updates there. So, question number one, how many times a day I should pin on Pinterest? Tailwind is going to enforce that we can save no more than 50 pins a day using their scheduler. However, 50 seems to be at the very top limit, and the recommended pinning volume is between 15 and 25 pins a day. Tailwind claims that if you want to pin more than this, you're exposing your account to unnecessary risk and hurting the distribution of your content on Pinterest. This leads to less engagement for your pins and less traffic to your website. Question number two. How many times I can repin the same pin to different boards? Tailwind will enforce a maximum of 10 boards in the board list you are choosing to save your pin to. If you decide to save your pin to more than 10 boards, you will see an alert like this one from the Smart Guide feature. Question number three. What is the recommended interval between the pins when I save them to a list of boards? Previously on Tailwind, the minimum interval of pinning the same pin to different boards was only 10 minutes. A lot of people abuse this and used to save the same pin to multiple boards in the same day. If you follow me on this channel for a while now, you know that I'm always telling you guys, be very careful with this. It's called repetitive pinning and you can get your account suspended very easily for this. Well, now if you use Tailwind, the new minimum interval is 2 days. Yep, you hear that right. You should not even save the pin once a day. Once in every 2 days is what Pinterest recommends this year. Now, question number four. How many new pin images I should create per page? Isn't it considered spammy if I create 5 different images for one page on my site? No, it's not spammy at all. It's actually what Pinterest wants from us. Obviously, it doesn't mean that you should save all the 5 different pins in one day because they will be linked to the same page. It only means that Pinterest prefers that the percentage of new images, fresh pins on your account is higher than the amount of duplicate pins. And by the way, the definition of a duplicate pin has evolved. Previously, Pinterest and Tailwind said that duplicates were the pins with the exact image and URL combination saved to a specific board more than once. Now, if you go and check Tailwind's Help Center article about duplicate pins, they actually removed the part about the pin being saved to the same board. It doesn't matter anymore if you saved this pin to another board previously. What matters now is that this exact combination of the pin image and the page URL has already been pinned on Pinterest before. Moreover, they added in the parentheses that it can be saved by you or anyone else, which means that if you repin something saved by other users from your site with the same pin image and the same URL combination, you're also creating duplicate pins. The good news is that if you're following me on YouTube, you know I've been talking about it for a year now. Pinterest wants fresh content and rewards accounts that are able to consistently produce fresh pins for the platform. You could ask me, but why Pinterest is so obsessed with fresh pins? Well, because historically, about 80% of all the content on Pinterest platform were just repins and not original images. There is just one research I can quote on this number, and Pinterest obviously never shared their official reports about the share of repins. And it says that 80% of all content on Pinterest are repins and only 20% are new images saved to the platform. And I'm sure that even nowadays Pinterest platform consists mostly of repins. Just think about it. Some of the most popular viral pins on the platform can get 10, 20,000 repins or even more. So each of those viral pins is a source of thousands and thousands of repins. Obviously, it is a real struggle for Pinterest to keep the share of their fresh content higher on the platform. What became even more obvious to me after watching this live session with Pinterest and Tailwind is that Pinterest is already twisting their algorithm in order to surface more fresh content on the platform. And in the future, this trend will only get stronger. So what's the conclusion for us content creators? Well, the conclusion is we have to find our way to create multiple unique pin images for each page on our website to maximize distribution of our pins on Pinterest. I already published a video on my channel where I'm showing you how you can create 5 different versions of a pin in Canva really quickly within about 10 minutes. So I will give you a link to that video in the top right corner and in the description below this video. And I'm also about to publish a new video that will show you how you can do it even faster and easier in Adobe Spark. So if you don't want to miss my new tutorials on this channel, then subscribe and hit that bell button to get notifications about my new videos. Now, question number 5. How different should be those pin versions from one another to be considered fresh pins? I hope Tailwind doesn't mind if I show you again an example from their best practices page, because I believe they have reviewed this example with Pinterest team, and this should demonstrate some of the elements on the image you could consider changing to create fresh pins. First, you can use different background photos, including slightly different angles. Second, you can create meaningfully different crops of the same image, which provides a new view or perspective on your pin. So you can focus on a specific object in the photo versus showing that object in a wider scene. I want you to pay attention here to the fact that just by changing the text overlay on your image, you're not following the best practices. Remember that Pinterest is a visual search engine, and they have mechanisms that allow the platform to recognize when the same exact image is used over and over again with a slightly different text overlay. And if you want to really follow the guidelines, you should strive to offer a substantially different experience or perspective for Pinterest users with your new fresh pin images. You probably know that I'm sharing the best comment in every week's video. So if you have something positive and inspiring to say and you want to get a free shout out on my channel, just leave your comments on my latest videos. And this week's shout out goes to a YouTube account called Big Blue. And here is what it says. As I've said before, all fact and no fluff. You know what you want to say and talk at a good pace. I have learned more from you than any other source I have come across. And I have often said that any day I learn something new which is worth knowing, then I have had a good day. Now all my Thursdays are good days. Well, thank you for this comment, and I can tell you honestly that Thursdays became my best days of the week since I started this channel because of all the kind feedback I'm getting from you guys, from my subscribers, so thank you.
If you're using Tailwind and you don't see any of these features, like I could show you on my account when this smart guide is gonna give you a warning because you're trying to save, for example, in this case, to more than 10 boards, or if you don't see this icon over here, you shouldn't worry because Tailwind is rolling out these features on all accounts within the next 2 weeks. I understand that the feature that's showing you these warnings about the minimum interval or how many boards you can save your pin to, this feature is called spam safeguard, and this icon over here, it belongs to this smart guide, and Tailwind says that initially what the smart guide will do, it will monitor all your pinning schedule and will alert you if you're going overboard with it. So apparently the smart guide feature is not seeing any violations. I'm not going overboard with any of my pins. I'm not saving too many pins linked to the same page in one day. The number of pins I schedule per day is fewer than 20, or maybe about, in some days, maybe on the weekends, I schedule about 25, 30 pins a day. But anyway, it's still way below the limit that is 50 pins per day, as we know that that will be the maximum Tailwind is gonna allow us. And then in the future, this smart guide feature is going to always keep us updated on any best practices that Pinterest is going to communicate to Tailwind team. They're not going to probably publish any of these recommendations on their official pages, of Pinterest pages, because like I said, that would give too much information for people who want to abuse the system, but they will probably indirectly let us know what are the best practices when Tailwind is changing anything in this smart guide.
I'm sure, guys, you might have a ton of other questions to ask, and I encourage you to do so in the comments below this video. These were the fundamental questions and answers you needed to know about Pinterest best practices from now and moving forward. And of course, if you want to always stay updated when changes like this happen, I invite you to join my Pinterest SEO Traffic Secrets program, where you get access to me in my private student-only Facebook group. I'm answering all the questions daily in that group. Yes, every single day, so you will never feel alone or lost while you're building your presence on Pinterest. I will give you a link to my program in the top right corner and in the description below this video. If you found this video helpful, give me a thumb up, leave some feedback in the comments below, and subscribe to get more of my Pinterest tips, which go live here on this channel on Thursdays. Meanwhile, don't leave just yet. I picked for you some of my best videos that are perfectly complementary to what I was sharing with you today. So click here and there to watch those videos, and see you next time.